What's usability? Usability is how people actually use websites, whether a site is easy or hard for people to use. There's a lot of research into this subject for a simple reason. Websites with high usability succeed, while sites with poor usability fail. In this video, I'll talk about some basic usability concepts and how to make sure your business website is usable. Usability is driven by two rules. Number one, people are lazy. Number two, people are busy. They won't spend time trying to figure out your website, no matter how cool you think it is. If your site is hard to use, they'll find another one, and you just lost money. The key to usability is user-centered design, designing the site to meet the user's needs. This will increase your conversion rate. That means converting shoppers into customers. If your site is hard to use or isn't what people expect, they will leave. Once they go, they're gone. 88% of users won't return to a site after a bad experience. The first usability factor is performance. This is the technical issues that affect how well your site works. It goes without saying that if your website is down, people won't be able to use it. So how do you prevent this? By using high-quality hosting. Good hosting will be faster, more reliable, and more secure than cheap hosting. Don't be tempted by those $1.99 a month deals. Good hosting will cost about $30 a month, and it's money well spent. Here are a few good companies. One of my clients used cheap hosting and her site was hacked. The site was down for 3 months. Can you afford to lose your business for 3 months just to save a few dollars? Loading time is how long it takes your site to appear when someone goes to it. 53% of people surveyed by Google say they would leave a website if it takes longer than 3 seconds to load. Like server uptime, the best way to get a fast-loading site is to use high-quality hosting. As you or your developer make changes to your site over time, it's easy to lose track of details, like links that no longer connect to anything. When people click on these, they'll get a 404 error. Make sure everything on your site does what it's supposed to do. If something doesn't work properly, fix it or remove it. Your website needs to look good on all devices, computers, tablets, and phones. This is called responsive design, and it's now the standard in the business. Many people use their phone as their primary internet device. 52% of global internet traffic comes from mobile devices. For some types of businesses, this number is even higher. That's why it's critical that your website looks good on a phone. About 15% of people have some sort of disability that makes it harder for them to access websites, ranging from color blindness to cognitive impairments. If you don't want to lose 15% of your business, make sure your website meets accessibility guidelines. The next factor is clarity. This is how easy it is to use your site and for people to find the information they're looking for. It's important because if someone can't find what they need, they won't spend time looking for it. They'll leave. Several factors contribute to clarity. The first is simplicity. Follow the KISS method. Keep it simple, stupid. People aren't interested in spending all day on your site. They want to find what they're looking for and get on with their lives. The first element of simplicity is called site architecture. This is a fancy term for how the information on your site is organized. All of the important information should be on the home page because most people won't go beyond that. This does not mean that everything should go on the home page, like this one, or this one. The second element is the site layout, how things are arranged on the page. The site architecture relates directly to the layout of the pages. Here are a few good examples, and some bad ones. It should be quickly obvious what your site is about. You do this with relevant images and strong headlines. People shouldn't have to read very much to know what you can do for them. Here's a good example of this. You have 4 seconds to grab the user's attention. Here are a few examples. A good layout guides the user's eyes to what you want them to see. This requires white space, empty areas on the page. This is not wasted space. It's a critical design element. Here are a few examples. Your website needs to be intuitive to use. Whatever you want people to do should be obvious. Here are a few examples. If you want people to click a button, make it easy to see, like in these examples. Guide the user through the steps you want them to take. Avoid unnecessary effects in animation, such as these examples. People don't come to your site for a show. They're looking for a solution to their problem. Don't use video just to use video. It needs to be relevant to whatever you're selling. Videos can also be a powerful selling tool. It's a great way to explain something in more detail. Never have something important only in a video. Many people won't watch it. Here's a typical bad corporate video, all effects and no content. And here's a good video that explains a process and answers questions.
The Content Pros writing service is crazy simple to use and incredibly easy to understand. First, simply submit an idea briefing for the type of content you'd like to create. Your dedicated production team then gets to work on creating your content. And finally, go back and forth on revisions as many times as you'd like until your content comes back absolutely perfect.
And don't use music at all. The next part of clarity is familiarity. Don't challenge people's expectations. People expect websites to work in certain ways. Here are a few of these. The logo should be in the top left part of the page. If you want people to call you, put the phone number in the top right. Use a horizontal navigation menu. Navigation is how people find what they're looking for. Why would you make this hard? There should be a maximum of 7 links in the main navigation menu. 5 is better. If you have a lot of pages, group relevant pages together into a submenu. Never, ever use 2 rows. Here are some examples of good and bad navigation. If you have a search function, put it in the header. Make sure it actually works and it doesn't search the entire internet. If your site is a single page, don't bother with search. Put any social media icons in the footer of the page. Don't use unusual layouts. Put things where people expect to find them. If things should line up, make sure they do. Don't try to be clever or edgy. The purpose of your site is not to win design awards, it's to make money for you. Everything that makes your site harder to use costs you money. Design considerations are also important for clarity. Here are a few tips. Don't go crazy with colors. Pick two or three colors and stick to those. You can find lots of color schemes online. Avoid overly bright colors. They look tacky and amateurish, like this or this. Here are a few good examples, and some bad ones.
A long, long time ago, on graduation day, you handed me your book. I signed this way, roses are red, my love, violets are blue, sugar is sweet, my love, but not as sweet as you. We dated through high school, and when the big day came, I wrote into your book, next to my name, roses are red, my love, violets are blue, sugar is sweet, my love, but not as sweet as you.
The final part of clarity is guidance. This means helping people find what they're looking for by guiding them to it. The main way to do this is to use a clear visual hierarchy. This is using visual cues to tell people what to read first. Think of a newspaper front page. The most important story is at the top of the page and has the biggest headline. Less important stories are farther down the page and have smaller headlines. That's a visual hierarchy. Your site should do the same thing. Readability. Since the most important thing on your site is the text, making sure it's easy to read is critical. Several factors go into this. The first thing most people think about regarding text is the typeface or font. In the early days of the web, fonts were very limited. Now the options are almost endless. Many designers use Google fonts. These are easy to implement and offer a wide selection. Before you go crazy, though, remember that the point of your text is for people to read it. Decorative fonts might look cool, but they're hard to read. Is this easy to read? Stick to basic fonts that are easy to read. Here are a few good choices. And whatever you do, don't use Comic Sans. I'm begging you. The next factor in readability is the size of the text. Many designers use type that is way too small. This is okay if your target market is teenagers, but many people, especially those over 40, don't have great eyesight. The type should be comfortable to read at a normal distance, at least 16 pixels. Line height is another important factor. This is the amount of space between lines. Use a line height of 130 to 150% of the type size. Don't center align paragraphs of text. It's hard to read. When you center headlines, sometimes one will have a word or two break onto the next line like this. It's not a good look. Avoid it by manually breaking the line like this. It looks better and is much easier to read. Centering is okay for headlines, but use left alignment for blocks of text. Never use justified text. Use all caps very sparingly, and never for a full sentence or paragraph. Related to the type size is the line length. Don't have your text go all the way across the page. Lines that are too long are harder to read. Sites that use a lot of type usually limit the lines to a shorter length, like this. Limit your line length to about 80 characters. Finally, the color you use for the type is important. The background color is also important. You need to have enough contrast between the two colors. The easiest combination to read is black text on a white background. White type against a dark background is okay, but use it sparingly. Don't use colored type against a colored background. It's too hard to read and looks tacky. Don't put text over a photo, like in this example. It's almost impossible to read. In the early days of the web, people often used repeating patterns for backgrounds like you see here. Don't do this. It's distracting, outdated, and makes the text hard to read. Use solid color backgrounds. Most of your text should be on a white background. Here are some examples of what not to do. Aside from the mechanics of the type, the writing itself also plays a part in readability. Here are a few tips. Organize your content properly. Break your text into small chunks. Don't have a long page of uninterrupted text. No one will read it. Use headings and subheads. People scan websites. They don't read the text from top to bottom. Headings allow them to quickly find what they're looking for. Don't be long-winded. Get to the point. You're not writing an English essay. Most Americans read at an 8th grade level. Most people only read 20% of the text, and you can't make them read the rest of it, no matter how good you think it is. Highlight key information by using bold, a different color, or some other effect, but don't use underlining. And don't overdo it. No more than 10% of the text should be emphasized. The last factor is relevance. Use relevant images and videos. E-commerce sites obviously need good photos of the products, but lead generation sites also benefit from good images. If you make something, you need high-quality photos of your work. Hire a professional photographer if you can. Don't use image cliches like these. If you see an image a lot, don't use it. Images are really important, so here's a bunch of examples. Focus on the problem and solution. People come to your website because they have a problem. They need to buy a dress, find a plumber, or contact an attorney. Whatever their problem is, your job is to provide the solution. Everything on your site should focus on this. Answer questions people might have in advance. An FAQ section is great for this. Don't forget to include some social proof, such as testimonials or reviews. If you have good reviews, make sure to put them on the site. Be sure to test your website. If you can't afford professional testing, ask a few people you know to sit in front of your site. Don't tell them what to do. Watch what they do and how they use the site, then make any necessary changes. Here are a few don'ts. Tiny clickable areas. Don't make it hard for people to find links. Forcing a login. Don't make people sign up for anything before they can get to your site. If you use a pop-up to get people to sign up for your email list, make sure it can be dismissed easily. CAPTCHAs. If you need to use a CAPTCHA on a form, use an easy one, not the one with the grid of pictures. Animated GIFs. Websites now support high-resolution video. No one's impressed by your crummy little waving flag animation. Long forms. If you have any kind of form on your site, only ask for the necessary information. For email opt-in, this means first name and email. Never ask for a phone number. Your sign-up rate will drop by 90%. Here are some final examples of good and bad usability. If you can keep all these things in mind as you create your site or have a developer create it for you, your site and your business will be much more successful.
If you need a professional, marketing-focused website that really works for you but don't think you can afford one, go right now to websiteinoneweek.com